here on the plantation from the river clay. And at the time they were made and after they were fired, the color that they became was the color of your blue jeans, denim blue.
Oh, yeah?
Those right. Columns begin pyramiding out into 72 brick pyramids, each one of them touching each other in the four different directions, going under that house as far as 8 feet into the ground. Mm. So it's for that reason the house has not moved in almost 200 years.
Pete, we're told as a young man he has a terrible, terrible temper. He kills his father's best friend in a duel at only 19 years old. Now, of course, that angered his father greatly, which time he grabs a pistol, chases... The old families living here along the river not only had all these places. This was their place of business, where they raised their sugar cane. They also had townhouses in the French Quarter. Wanted these. And if you look closely, you'll see they're porous on the outside, and from the neck inside, they all glazed. Every household had at least four. What they did with them, they took them, buried them into the ground up to the neck. Once those jars are buried, they got saturated with moisture and actually got as cold as 47 degrees. And then they hired go into the swamp where all these trees were growing, cut them, dried them, and marked them. On the site is another group who were making all the bricks and laying the foundation for the house. All the preparation for the building of the house takes 11 months. When everything was ready, they bring the wood right back here to the site, and they actually assemble the whole superstructure of this house in just 11 days.
Wow.
It's called brick between post construction. 30 vertical beams, 30 horizontal posts. Everything fits into one another. Not a nail holds it all together. Well, we knew that the men that built this place were already doing it for hundreds of years in West Africa. And the reason this construction works so well is because of the similarities in our climate.
That's where it was built
originally, right there. That was her retirement house. So because she's part of the family, she could still live within the area. The architects are taking a giant U-shaped house and making it into a T-shaped house to the back of it. All this Victorian frou-frou and another item, the front door. This is a Creole house built in 1805, no front door because they never used it. In 1805, this area right here was a wall, and right here were two doorways known as brisées. Parlor and bedroom for the oldest man in the family business. So if this gentleman occupying this room had a guest, he would have met him there, brought him here into this room. On most occasions, it was a small party where he had a couple gentlemen who were coming to visit, just socially talk, maybe play cards, etc., etc. If they brought ladies, from the Spanish word, criollo is a Spanish word, which means mixture. In the strictest sense of the word, a Creole is the firstborn of a European parent in the colonies. It's not too bad. You'll notice something else that's unusual, like there's no left or right shoe.
I thought it was lower. Oh,
that's right. No. Now, this is the ladies' parlor. So this would have been the bedroom and parlor for the oldest woman in the family business. Again, you know, she and her husband occupied this room as their bedroom. This room, though, had two other very important uses. Ladies were running this plantation for more than 80 years. They conducted all their business right here in this room. So,
Well, you know, in reality, he never really wanted to be a plantation.
Somewhat hidden by the kitchen garden are two others. The plantation originally had 69 of them, going 3.5 miles into the land. Now every evening, the slaves returned to their homes. They enjoyed telling stories to their children. We had a young neighbor that lived perhaps 3 miles upriver from us, El Say Forche. That young man was found many evenings with the slaves, listening to the stories they were telling and writing down 20 that he heard. Now he grew up and he became president of the National Folklore Society, and for a time he was also dean at Tulane University. Well, he has a great opportunity to collaborate with several other gentlemen from around the country. One of these gentlemen, Joel Chandler Harris from Atlanta, Georgia. Now the two of them were talking and they both realized they were listening to the same stories that the slaves had been telling their children. And all the stories they were listening to, not about life on anybody's plantation. These stories have been told to the children of West Africa for hundreds of years. It was then used as a classroom for the very young children. And someone was awake and on duty every single night. There would be someone wide awake in case they had to...
Dismount or something? Or
well, no, in case of an emergency. So if there was a fire or flood, they could wake everyone up and get them, you know, to safety.
They would
stay over the house, actually. It's basically pretty much, yeah, we tried to do it pretty much the same. This is Cyprus, by the way.
This is New Sacramento, you know, not, definitely not 2,000 years old. But yeah, so this is what we're waiting to.